Don't you ever get bored of the default ringtones on iPhone? That is why I wanted to change the default ringtone on my iPhone. And since I did it, so I want to show you how you can set any song as custom ringtone on your iPhone without a computer. Hey everyone, Rahul here from Tech Revo, and welcome back to another episode. In this video, you will learn how to set any song as custom ringtone on any iPhone without iTunes or computer. But before that, a quick sponsored message for you. This video is brought to you by my free online courses. If you want to turn your digital presence into profits, visit affiliatesalesautomation.com to get free access to my online courses. All right, now without wasting any more time, let's get started. In order to set any song as custom ringtones on any iPhone, you need only two apps. The first one is Garageband, which is the official music recording studio app provided by Apple. It is completely free and chances are it would have already been installed on your iPhone. In case it's not installed on your iPhone, simply open App Store and search for GarageBand. Then download it and you are ready to proceed for steps to set any song as custom ringtone on your iPhone. But wait, you will need the second app as well, which is a file downloader app. If your iPhone is running on iOS 12 or earlier, you may search and download free apps like Documents by Riddle. I have already created a video about the best document apps for iPhone. You may find the link to watch that video in the description below. However, if your iPhone is running on iOS 13 or later, then you don't need any third-party file downloader or browser. Thanks to iOS 13, which provides a built-in download manager in Safari, and I'll be using that for the demonstration purposes in this video. Alright, now it's time to learn how to set custom ringtones on your iPhone. So pay close attention to what I'm doing now, because this will not only help you customize your iPhone's ringtone, but also the message tone on your iPhone. First of all, open Safari and go to any music download sites to download the music file which you want to set as a custom ringtone on iPhone. In case you don't know, downloading copyrighted music from any random song downloading site is illegal. So do your due diligence before downloading copyrighted songs. To avoid any copyright issue on my channel, I have already got the music file in my Google Drive and I'll copy and paste my drive file link in Safari to open it. Now, if you tap the download icon, the Safari downloader will lead you to the prompt. Since I am running iOS 13, that's why I have got a prompt window asking me whether I want to download or I want to view this. So if you don't see this prompt, chances are you are running on iOS 12 or earlier. Alright, so now I'll tap on download and here in the top right corner, you will see this little download manager icon. Tapping on this will show me all my downloads. Okay, so now we have downloaded our music file. But where is the file being downloaded? To know the location of your downloaded song file, just click on the little magnifying glass icon. And this will take you to the file's application and the location where the file is downloaded. Here, in my case, the file is in the downloads folder on my iPhone. If you want, you may also change the download location into the Safari browser. However, now we have downloaded the song that we want to set as a custom ringtone on the iPhone, so it's time to move on to the next step. Open the GarageBand application, which we have recently installed from the App Store. So this is what we have got after launching the application, but we need to find out voice recorder. To find it out, swipe from right or left. Once you have found it, tap on it and it'll open. Now on the top left, here you will see little grid icons. Tap on the third icon. This will bring up a new page. The blank space will be used to work on the music file which we have downloaded. Now it's time to import the song. To import the song, tap on this Omega icon. And here you will get Apple Loops, Files and Music tabs. If you have got your song in the Apple Music library, then you can also select your music from the library. To do that, simply tap on the Music tab and then search for the song which you want to set as a custom ringtone on your iPhone. But since we have already downloaded the song from the web, so we will tap on the Files tab. Now it's time to browse the music file from the Files app. So tap on Browse and select the desired location. The downloaded file must be available in the recent. But if not, try navigating to the location where the file is. In my case, the music file is in the downloads folder on iPhone. So I'll go all the back to the locations and here I'll select on my iPhone. Now downloads. And here it is. Select the song and wait for a few seconds until the song appears. Tap and hold the music file and drag it to the blank space. Next, tap on this plus icon which is on the top right corner and change the bars from 8 to 30. In order to change the bars, tap on section A having 8 bars and tap on the upper arrow and set the bars to 30. This is necessary because 30 bars means 30 seconds of the song and 30 seconds is the maximum time allowed by Apple for any ringtones. Alright, now we are into the GarageBand timeline. So here's the timeline and let's jump into this to select the clip and trim the part of the song which is irrelevant. For example, I want to cut off the starting part of the song, so I'll tap on this and drag it to the right side from where the song is starting. Just like this. Nice, but what if I want to select the mid part of the song? Hang on, let me tell you. To select the mid part of the song, drag the starting point to the right. This will shorten the file. Now select and drag the song towards the first bar. And now drag the last portion to the last bar as I am doing. I want to select this part of the song, so I'll trim the song from where that part is starting. You can also preview your selection by tapping on this play button. Alright, let's do the final review of the song. Well, I'm getting some click sound. If you are also getting some click sound, then tap on this button left to the Omega icon. And now, let's get a preview again. Everything is fine now. It's time to export the custom ringtone for your iPhone. Tap on this file-like icon in the top left corner. This denotes the save button. Now tap and hold on the file. This will bring up the options. Select the save button and on the next screen, tap on ringtones. Now you can rename and customize the name of the ringtone and tap on export. It is being exported as the ringtone for your iPhone. Now if you want to set this custom ringtone as your standard ringtone, then tap on set ringtone as and then select standard ringtone or standard text tone depending upon your choice. You may also set this custom song as your standard ringtone using an alternate method. Go to settings, then sounds and tap on ringtone. Here you will see the custom ringtone that we have just exported. Tap on this and now this has been set as the standard ringtone on your iPhone. So that is how you can set any song as the custom ringtone on your iPhone. The method is pretty easy and in the same way, you may also set any song as custom text message tone on your iPhone. If you enjoyed watching this video, please like and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to TechEuropro channel and tap on the bell icon as that way you won't miss any future updates. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below and I'll be happy to answer. Thanks for watching. I'm Rahul signing off and I'll see you in the next one.